I've been following the Boardwalk Empire show, which is fantastic. Scorsese and a bunch of directors have done a great job recreating the period. What's that like to step back and play in that sort of setting?
Well, it's a dream come true, really. I mean, I have been living in the 1920s musically for about 55 years now. Except I was this odd person, you know, who's like, what's with Vince and that cartoon music or that Little Rascals music? Because that's what kids my age would say. And now, finally, I don't have to apologize about it. Hey, you know, this music is finally in a good series. I mean, I've done movies before utilizing old music, a bunch of Woody Allen films. This bug is trying to take my spotlight here. You know, did you see that?
Yeah.
That's show business for you. And the Cotton Club and the Aviator. But I think the Boardwalk Empire is probably the biggest thing that's happened for this music in a long time.
Yeah, I wonder about that. It's one of the highest-rated shows on Sunday night.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think this opens up a mainstream audience to this music?
Or? Most definitely. Yeah. You know, I always tell folks that a bunch of years ago when the Sting movie came out, all of a sudden there was this giant resurgence of interest in Scott Joplin and associated ragtime of that period, and these young classical pianists all of a sudden would be gathering up Joplin, and people were playing Joplin, and it was amazing. It was a real renaissance for Scott Joplin, and I always dreamt that someday a vehicle, a movie or a show, or brought, you know, something that would capture America or the world, and started looking back to the 1920s to explore some of the great hot tunes of that time.
Yeah. I'm not sure if you pay attention, but what's the reception among people or critics or media? What are they saying about it?
Well, I'd say the majority of the folks like it. You know, you can't please everyone. That I learned in the music business. You know, you could play the greatest, hottest tune, and there'd be someone that said, well, you know, I didn't think that much of it. So, you know, the naysayers, you know, there's always that. But for the most part, they're getting great awards. They're winning Golden Globe Awards, and the actors, and the scripts, and the CD that we're on is up for a Grammy tomorrow. So I'm keeping my fingers and my toes crossed for that, and we'll see what happens. Even just being nominated is thrilling enough. I mean, you know, it's probably the furthest that I've gone with my music career in all these years. And I've done some wonderful things, like working for Dick Hyman and 10 other film directors and stuff.
Well, we're having a great time. Thanks for
being
here to play.
Thank you so much for taking the time to interview me, and I hope I made some sense in this little piece.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yep.